Welcome to another module of the Strategies for Professional Growth course. As you can see, this is an outbound training program or a session. You can see we are outdoors right now. All the activities related to the session will be outdoors. Why this outbound training? This outbound training, as the course indicates, it is about learning strategies for growing professionally. And one of the key things that we see in joining a corporate or in work atmosphere is to be able to work along with other people, right? As a team, when you have to work, you need to get along with people, you need to be able to communicate well with them so that the group effect actually shows up, okay? As you can see in some of these group activities, as you can see, when Leander Paes and Mahesh Bhupathi were playing singles tournaments, they had some rank, but that was a very rank that was very far away from the top rank. But when the two came together and played as a doubles team, they were number one, right? So this group effect came into picture, and they were able to get along very well in terms of being a team, and could win matches that way. They were number one for a very long time. So what is very important here is we learn that group effect is going to fetch much more of a result compared to just individuals. Though individuals will have their own strengths, a group brings out all the strengths together as a synergistic effect, and you will see that in the results. Now, you have a person who has gone through this, who has trained so many people in the army. What more would you need in terms of introducing this kind of outbound training to you? And there you have Colonel Jaikumar, who will introduce to you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the program that will follow. It's always a great privilege and honor to be inside the campus, the only forested campus within a city. I was told it is in the entire Asia, you can't find such a place. The greenery is something for which we cannot see elsewhere, anywhere in a city, one. And two, the kind of buoyant mood one gets to see among the students, whether it is the students or the young faculty, even the elderly faculty, everyone moving about in cycles. There is no timing here. It is 24/7. 24/7 is including the laboratories, including something called Center for Innovation, which Professor Siva is the one who is the mastermind behind that. Whether it is cycling around, whether it is tea shop, the amount of number of tea shops that you opened here, everything is really amazing in this place. And add to it the credit of introducing outbound training as a part of life skills course in our institute. And therefore, we thought it should not be missed for any class which is related to professional growth. All right, as Professor Siva has already told you all, this is all about working in a team. While working in a team, we not only get an insight into our own personality traits, our own limitations in some situations, we also get to know the strengths of the people working around us, our team members. In fact, sir, I must tell you that a few years ago, there was one IT company which came along with me to a place called Yelagiri here. After 2 days of training, there was one part of the program was, we are not going to do all of OBT here. We are just giving a sample of two activities. Therefore, I thought I must mention this. So, one of the activities that those people were made to do was, the team of about 80 of them were there, participants, and we made them into 40 pairs, buddy pairs.
Mm.
And the instruction given was, all right, gentlemen, ladies, your buddy pair is now injured and he / she cannot walk. The nearest medical aid is about 50 meters away. We drew a line and these people were in one line here. And I said, now please take your buddy there. Get, okay. get your friend.
In whatever way.
Whatever way you want, you do. Now they didn't know what to do. They didn't know how to pick up also. They can't
whether to pick
like
up like this or
many,
the back or the
like
shoulder.
They did everything and finally with a little bit of hints, people put the buddies on the shoulder like this, like a lamb we have on our shoulders. Some picked them on the piggyback like we do in the schools and they started running. So that's not what is important here. What is important here is, after those 2 days of activities in outbound training, we could notice people were sitting close to each other, giggling and talking, shouting, yelling, everything. The kind of bonding was great. The seniors...
just after this one single activity.
Just these 2 days of... just after this activity made a lot of...
Made a lot of difference.
Probably that is the personal touch one gets into.
That one has the strength to take the other all the way.
All the way there.
Which they didn't realize before.
Yes, yes. That probably had a great impact upon the thinking, upon the perception, upon many things within every individual.
So, some kind of bonding starts
bonding.
To happen.
During the feedback, one of the, not one, more than one, they told us that they have been in the same office for over a year and they have not spoken to each other at all.
Look at what it is.
They have not spoken to each other because they were sitting facing their backs. One fellow is looking this side, the other person is looking that side in that cubicle. So, that's what it is. We are going to look primarily at completing a task, not as an individual, but as a group. It is primarily a fun activity and I would advise you all to look for each of the individual's actions and behavior within the group, how they are able to look at the bigger picture, how an individual's contribution is taken by the team or rejected by the team, and how one feels when something is not going the way it is supposed to be going. And all such things are there.
So, to be observant and immersed in it.
Immerse yourself into this program.
Mm.
You will find they will, one, plan. The first thing that they will all be doing is, like any other task, they have to plan. They have to see the resources available.
You have
to
plan.
Them.
Mm. See, the resources also. See, each one will have a resource. Will be a resource.
Each individual by himself or herself
will
is
be
a resource. And they have to look for something.
Correct.
Somebody who is a well-built fellow who can lift something very easily. Something who can sneak into some small little part and get the work done. So, all those things are...
And somebody, strangely, sometimes you find the skill there that you did not notice earlier.
We did not notice. So, this planning issue is there and looking for resource available is there. Then keeping in mind the time constraint, for example, any project that you would see, we will always be running against time. Here also, we will put some kind of...
Some of them will be very tensed. Some of them just will be thinking about what to do.
Yes, yes.
But eventually, it gets done.
Eventually, they all merge and get the task completed. So, mid-course correction will be the next aspect which the people will be looking at. Another thing is, pepping up people who are lagging behind. That
fantastic.
Is very important
fantastic.
Because the strength of a group lies in the weakest link. I'm sure all of us heard this. So you have to ensure that whoever is not so much capable of doing a particular thing, please give him or her the shoulder and help her get over the whatever difficulty he or she faces.
Fantastic.
That's what is the team spirit all about. So, shall we go, sir?
Yes.